Hello, student and my fellow viewers. Welcome to Mr. Wanyoike Digital Learning Platform. In front of you, Mr. Wanyoike, a chemistry teacher. In today's lesson, we are in lesson number 3 on the mole concept, and I'm going to put more emphasis on calculation of the empirical formula, especially the complex questions. On to the first example, I'm going to refer to an example here. There is a compound, an example one in today's lesson. We have a compound has an empirical formula of C3H6O and a relative mass of 116. Question number one, you are supposed to determine its molecular formula, given that the relative atomic mass of H is 1, carbon is 12, and oxygen is 16. And therefore, in this question, you can see it is well illustrated. You are first given the empirical formula given by C3H6, then O is 1. There is only one atom of oxygen as far as the empirical formula is concerned. And its molecular mass is given as 116. And therefore, what you are supposed to do, you are supposed to ask yourself, what is the molecular mass of the empirical compound? Given the empirical formula is given as C3H6O, and what are you supposed to get? You are supposed to get the empirical mass of that compound, and therefore carbon, you are given the relative atomic mass of carbon is 12, but you have to multiply by 3. Because there are 3 atoms of carbon in that compound, and then you add to 1, you multiply by 6. Why 1? The relative atomic mass of hydrogen is given as 1, and because there are 6, you have to multiply by 6 so that you can add all the 6 atoms of hydrogen. Then finally, you add 16, which is the relative atomic mass of oxygen, and therefore you are supposed to get 36 here. Then you add to 6, then you add to 16, and therefore after calculation you will find that the relative formula mass or the empirical mass of this compound is given as 58, and therefore 36 plus 6 you'll get 42, and 42 you add 16, you will end up getting 58 as the empirical mass. Then from there you go to the next step, and that is you relate the empirical mass then you multiply by the number of molecules which are involved in order for you to get the molecular mass. That is the second formula that you are going to use, and therefore as we had already indicated, the empirical formula we are already given as C3H6O into bracket N. N refers to the number of molecules which are involved in the formation of the molar mass, and therefore you are supposed to equate it with the molar mass, and the molar mass in this case we are given as 116, and therefore you equate to 116, and therefore previously we had calculated the empirical mass, and the empirical mass was 58, and therefore the empirical mass of this represented by the empirical formula here, the empirical mass becomes 58. Then you multiply by n, you are supposed to get 116. And therefore, the value of n, the number of molecules which are involved in formation of the molecular formula, you are supposed to get 116. You divide by 58, and the answer becomes 2. After obtaining 2 as the value of the number of molecules, therefore, you are going to relate this formula. That is a molecular formula, formula is given by the empirical formula. That is our empirical formula was CH3H6O. Then you multiply by the number of N. The number of N in this case is 2. So you place 2 there. And therefore you open the bracket, you'll get C is equals to 6 and H is equals to 12. And oxygen, there are only 2 there, and that becomes our molecular formula. That becomes our molecular formula. And in our second question, still on the first example, you are supposed to calculate the percentage of carbon. You calculate the percentage of carbon in the compound. And whenever you are asked such a question, you're supposed to come up with the molecular mass or the empirical mass. And in this case, we have the molecular formula being C6H12O2, and the molecular mass is given as 116. That is 6 you multiply by 12, and 12 you multiply by 1 because the relative atomic mass of hydrogen is 1, and you add to 32, that is oxygen, the relative atomic mass of oxygen is 16, so you multiply by 2, and therefore the overall, if you add those masses, you will end up getting 116. But in this question, we are asked, you calculate the percentage of carbon, and therefore there are six carbon. The mass of carbon is in the compound, mass of carbon in the compound is given as 6 atoms, and each atom has a relative atomic mass of 12. And therefore, after computation, after you get 6, you multiply by 12, you are supposed to get 72. And percentage of carbon now, percentage of carbon in the compound, becomes 72. You divide by the molecular mass, which was supposed to be 116. Then you multiply by 100%, and after computation, you are supposed to get 62.07%. And therefore, as far as that question is concerned, you are supposed to get the percentage of carbon as 62.07. You are supposed to get 62.07, as you can see, it is well illustrated on the white board. You can see the question was a compound has an empirical formula of C3H6O, there is only one atom of oxygen in that compound, and relative molecular mass. There is an omission, it should be a relative molecular mass, of 116. And the question was determine its molecular formula. And therefore, you are supposed to calculate, as I have already discussed in that session, you get the empirical mass of the compound given, and the empirical mass I have already demonstrated in this question. The answer becomes 58. And after getting the empirical mass, you equate this formula of empirical mass, you multiply by n. Remember, n refer to the number of molecules of empirical formulas which are involved in the formation of the molar mass or the molecular formula. And therefore, after that, you will end up getting 58, which was the empirical mass. The empirical mass, that is 58, you multiply by the number of molecules, then you equate it to the molar mass, which is supposed to be 116. Then you get the value for n is 2, and you come and you substitute it in the formula here so that you can get the molecular formula as C6. Remember, you multiply, you open the bracket by multiplying by 2, 3 you multiply by 2, you get 6, 6 you multiply by 2, you get H12, and 1 oxygen. You multiply by 2, you will get 2 oxygen, and that becomes the molecular formula. On to the second example, as I put more emphasis so that you can remember, you can see that you are required to calculate the percentage of carbon in the compound. And therefore, you can take the compound as using the molecular formula, that is C6, H12, oxygen, they are supposed to be 2, and the molecular mass, as we were given here on the question, should be 116, and therefore you put it there. Then after that, you determine the mass of carbon in the compound. How many carbons are there in the molecular formula of this compound? They are supposed to be 6. So you multiply by the relative atomic mass of one carbon, and the answer becomes 72. And after that, you are supposed to calculate the percentage of carbon in the compound as 72, representing the total mass of the carbon in that compound. You divide by the molar mass of the compound, then you multiply by 100%, and you are going to get 62.07%. On to the second example. I'm going to give the example number 2 here. And in the second example number 2, I'm supposed to come up with a question that we are, which will show us the relationship between the empirical formula, the relationship between the empirical formula and how do we get the empirical formula and the molecular formula. The second example also shows us the relationship between the empirical formula and the molecular formula. In this example, the example number 2, it states you are given on complete combustion of a sample of hydrocarbon, supposed to be a sample of hydrocarbon 3.52 grams of carbon, 4 oxide, and 1.44 grams of water was formed. Determine the molecular formula. Molecular formula of the hydrocarbon, given that into bracket, relative molecular mass of Hydrocarbon is 56. Carbon 4 peroxide is given as 44. And water, there is a comma there, water is given as 18. Remember, the formula for water is H2O, so you can as well write as H2O is given as 18. And relative atomic mass of H is equals to 1, and C, that is carbon, is equals to 12. So in this question, what are you supposed to do? In this particular question, you are supposed to determine. You are supposed to determine the molecular formula of the hydrocarbon, and therefore, which is the first step. The first step that you are supposed to take, you are supposed to calculate the mass of the mass of carbon in the carbon 4 peroxide produced. And therefore, in our solution here, we are given the mass of carbon 4 peroxide as 3.52 grams. And therefore, what is the mass? You ask yourself, what is the mass of carbon in the carbon 4 peroxide? And you're supposed to take the value, the relative atomic mass of carbon, you are supposed to get it as 12, as it is well illustrated here. C is given by 12, that is the relative atomic mass of carbon. But the relative molecular mass of carbon 4 peroxide supposed to be 44. Therefore, you divide by 44, then you multiply by the total mass, which is supposed to be 3.52 grams, and therefore you are supposed to get the answer as 0.96 grams of carbon. And in the second reasoning, you are supposed to get the mass. You are given mass of water produced during combustion of the hydrocarbon, and the mass of the water produced was given as 1.44 grams, and therefore you are supposed to ask yourself, what is the mass of hydrogen in the water molecule. So how do you get it? You're supposed to know that there are two atoms of hydrogen in one molecule of water, and therefore each hydrogen, the relative atomic mass of each hydrogen is 1. So 1, you multiply by 2, you will get 2. You divide by the relative formula mass of this molecule, and for water was given as 18, and 18 is calculated by taking 2. The value for the relative atomic mass of hydrogen is 1. You multiply by 2, you get 2. Then you add the relative atomic mass of oxygen, which are supposed to be 16. So 2, you add to 16, you get 18. And therefore, the denominator becomes 18. Then you multiply by the mass, which was supposed to be 1.44 grams. And therefore, the answer becomes what? The mass of hydrogen in the water is supposed to be equal to 2, you divide by 18, you multiply by 1.44 grams, and you can take a calculator. And in this calculator, you just put 2, you put 2, you divide by 18, then you are supposed to multiply by 1.44, and the answer becomes 0.16. As you can see, it is well illustrated on the calculator. Then from there, you will indicate it, 0.16 that is grams of hydrogen on the water molecule produced. Then previously, during the previous lesson, I explained how you are supposed to calculate the empirical formula, and you must come up with a table. And in this table, you write the elements, and after writing the elements, you are supposed to have two elements, that is carbon, and there is hydrogen, because it is a hydrocarbon. And in form one, you were well taught what is a hydrocarbon. A hydrocarbon is a compound which is made up of two elements, that is carbon and hydrogen only. So a hydrocarbon is a compound which is made up of carbon and hydrogen atoms only. And therefore, as far as this question is concerned, you will write the masses, the mass of each for the carbon was supposed to be 0. We calculated here, you can remember, in our previous calculation, the mass of carbon in this example is supposed to be 0.96 grams of carbon, and that is 0.96. I can write the mass in grams. Then the mass of hydrogen, you can see we have calculated the mass of hydrogen, and we have gotten it as 0.16. 0.16, those are grams. Then you write the relative atomic mass. The relative atomic masses, or mass of carbon, should be 12, and the relative atomic mass of hydrogen is 1. And therefore, in order for you to get the moles, the formula for getting the moles, you are supposed to get mass, you divide by relative atomic mass. And therefore, using this formula here, you are supposed to come up with the moles of carbon, which was contained in the carbon 4 oxide produced. And therefore, in this case, you will take your calculator and you divide the mass. The mass, remember, the mass of carbon is 0.96, you divide by 12. And therefore, you are supposed to take 0.96, you divide by 12, which is the relative atomic mass of carbon, and the answer becomes 0.08. And therefore, you write it as 0.08. And after that, you proceed to the second one, that is the moles of hydrogen. And the moles of hydrogen, since the mass is 0.16 and the relative atomic mass of hydrogen is 1, you just divide 0.16, divide by 1, and you'll get 0.16. And now you will come to the mole ratio. And in our mole ratio, you take the largest number, you divide by the smallest number, and the largest moles, the largest value of moles in this case is 0.16. So you are supposed to divide each and every term here by 0.08. And therefore, 0.08, you divide by 0.08, you will get 1. And 0.16, you divide by 0.08, you will end up getting 2. And therefore, our mole ratio becomes 1:2. It means that our empirical formula in this case, carbon should be on the empirical formula. Formula for that compound should be the carbon is only 1, and the hydrogen, there are only 2 hydrogen atoms which are involved. And therefore, in order for us to determine the molecular formula as per the question, you can see in the question you are required to determine the molecular formula of the hydrocarbon. And therefore, as far as the molecular formula of the hydrocarbon is concerned, you're supposed to write it like this. You write the you start with empirical formula you multiply by n. The n is the number of molecules which are involved in formation of the molecular formula, molecules of empirical formula involved in formation of the molecular formula. So now is it, you equate it to molecular formula, molecular formula, formula, molecular formula. And therefore, if we want to get the molecular formula now, molecular formula, you will first write the empirical formula. Remember, it was H2 and we have N. And therefore, you have the value N there as representing the number of molecules which are involved in the formation of the molecular formula, the number of molecules of empirical formulas. And the value, how can we get that the value of N? Remember, in our question, we were given 56. We were given 56 as the relative molecular mass of hydrocarbon. And therefore, you are supposed to equate it. You equate, this is the molecular formula. You equate CH2 into bracket N with the 56. You are supposed to get 56. That is the molecular molecular mass. In other words, we can talk of empirical mass. You multiply by N, empirical mass. You multiply by the number of molecules of those empirical mass. You will end up getting the molar mass, molecular mass. And therefore, in this example, the empirical mass should be 12, because carbon is represented by 12, that is the relative atomic mass of carbon. Then you add 2. Why 2? Because each and every atom of hydrogen, there is only one relative atomic mass of hydrogen. And therefore, you multiply by 2, you get 2. Then you multiply by N, you will get 56. And therefore, this is 14N, you will get 56. And N, the value of N becomes 4. That is 56, you divide by 14, you will get 4. And therefore, as per the question, the molecular formula in this case becomes CH2, that is the empirical formula. You multiply by N, and remember N is represented by 4, because I have already demonstrated on how you are supposed to get the value of N. And therefore, our answer becomes CH2 into bracket 4. Then you open the bracket, you will get C, they are supposed to be 4, and H, you are supposed to get it as 8. And that is the molecular formula of our question. That is our molecular formula of this question. And that comes to the end of this example number 2. On to the third example.